attachment of jaw, that is lower jaw with the upper jaw, for efficient biting and chewing, known as jaw suspension. Today we are learning about jaw suspension. Without any further delay, let's start. There are different ways in which these attachments are attained depending upon the modification in visceral arches in vertebrates. Orthodistalic. This type of jaw suspension occurs in early bony fishes. In this type, the jaws are attached to the brain case by ligaments. The hyoid arch is complete like the posterior branchial arcs and it does not support the jaws. The gill cleft in front of the hyoid arch has complete gill. Amphistalic. This type of jaw suspension is characteristic of primitive shark such as Heptancus. In this case, the upper jaw has two areas of articulation, the basal and the ortic process. Ortic process is the post-orbital articular part of the plateau quadrate and also known as quadrate process. These two processes are attached to the chondrocranium by ligament. Beside this, high mandibular of the hyoid arch is attached to the chondrocranium at one end, and the other end, both the upper and the lower jaws are suspended to it. This type of jaw suspension, there is support both from the high mandibular and from the direct articulation of upper jaw and brain case. In other words, it is double suspension. Hyostylic. This type of jaw suspension found in most cartilaginous and bony fishes. In this case, the upper jaw has no direct connection with the brain and the both jaws are joined to the brain case entirely by the high mandibula of the hyoid arch. Orthostylic. This type of jaw suspension is found in few fishes. In orthostylic jaw, the upper jaw is fused tightly to the brain case and the lower jaw is suspended from the upper jaw.